Today's tech talk is all about squid fishing off the rocks. Me personally, I've never done this style of fishing before. In fact, all the squid that I've ever caught have been on the back of a game boat, a long way out to sea in the middle of the night. But luckily today, we're with two experts, and we're going to learn all about the different techniques and gear that's going to help you get the best out of your squid fishing. So I'm with Johnny from Shimano New Zealand, and we're going to go over all the gear that we're using. Shimano really captured the whole system really, really well. So you've got, you know, specific rods, reels, leader, line, and obviously lures to get the best out of your squid fishing. I mean, the first thing, Johnny, is the rod. I mean,
yeah, it's
a very long rod. What's some features of a good squid rod?
So you're really looking at a rod over 8 foot long. These are sort of 8'3" and 8'6". Yeah. That allows you to get a really big cast and get out over the foul and get to where the squid are.
Right, and I noticed when you're working these lures, it's a very whippy action.
Yep.
What's the dynamics of a rod for that?
Yeah, so the action is specifically designed for squid fishing, obviously. Nice and soft, so these are medium light power ratings, and that basically allows you to get the best action out of the lure, and then when you hook the squid, stops you from pulling the hooks out of the squid as well.
Right, okay. Now the reels have got quite a large spool on them. They're sort of a 3000 size. Why is that?
So yeah, so these are a C3000S type reel. So they're a 3000 size shallow spool. Basically, we're fishing very fine braid. We don't need an awful lot of it, so they're a nice shallow spool. But also having a larger diameter spool will help you cast further, reduces the amount of friction off the spool lip. So when you're casting a lightly weighted lure, it'll go further.
So we're using two different setups today. They're both price pointed. I'm using the Sephia BB setup, which is, you know, rod and reel combo. Johnny's using the high-end XR Sephia.
Yep, so there's sort of differences between the two rods. Your BB, it's more just a high power X blank.
Yeah.
That's probably the first thing. The XR's got the high power and the Spiral X core tape in the blank. So this blank's a bit crisper and it should outcast the BB rod.
Right. But both setups, they feel awesome. They're nice and light, really crisp. But looking at the XR setup, it's got a different butt section on there.
Yeah, so this has got a carbon monocoque butt system.
Yeah.
So this butt is actually full carbon all the way through. It's basically an extension of the blank. And it's hollow, super lightweight, and it transmits all the sensation from the lure straight into your hand. So you'll feel every little knock or tap or any tug from a squid on there.
Johnny, you're using the Sephia XR reel. I'm using the Sephia BB reel.
Yep.
What's the difference between these two great reels?
So again, the XR's a higher spec'd reel, so slightly better internals. It's got a carbon fibre body. It's also got a carbon fibre handle, so it's super light. It's only 175 grams, whole reel.
Right.
Whereas your BB is an alloy body, alloy handle. It's a bit heavier. And it doesn't have quite the same modern technology in there. This XR's also got the X-Protect waterproofing system,
yep.
Whereas your BB's only got the Core-Protect waterproofing system. So this is a higher level of durability.
Yeah. So to match up this complete system, we're using the Sephia braid, which is an 8 carrier. The 8 carrier is a great braid, very subtle, knots up really well. Part of the Shimano Sephia range or system, we've got the shock leader, which is fluorocarbon. We're using fluorocarbon because it's a lot less visible in the water. It's also a lot thinner diameter than monofilament, and the abrasion resistance is a lot stronger as well. Johnny, what size are we using today?
So we're using the 14 pound today to match the line, but we've also got an 11 pound. So if you're fishing from like the wharf or somewhere where you're less likely to get snagged, you can go down in leader. Off the rocks, you're better off with slightly heavier stuff so you don't lose your jigs.
So there's some really nice accessories in the Sephia range, with especially these cases for holding all our jigs.
Yeah, for sure. So we've got a 20-piece case here. So this has got little compartments inside for you to put your jigs in, and a compartment at the front to store your tools. And then you've got a 10-piece case, which is like your wallet style there, which is more suited to being put in a backpack, etc.
So another great feature of the cases is they're all washable. We've got breathable mesh here, synthetic materials. So you can come in from the end of the day, give it all a rinse off, and you know that they're not going to go rusty and everything's going to dry in your mesh case. And yours is very similar there, Johnny, as well.
Yeah, likewise, your 20-piece case has got holes in the bottom, so you can actually just run the hose straight through it if you want to, or you can remove your little capsules with your jigs in there and take them out to wash as well.
So what's that you got in your hand there, Johnny?
This is actually the Shimano Sephia Icky Spike, so it's extendable, so you don't hurt yourself with it, and that's just designed to keep your squid in the best possible eating condition. Just like a fish, you want to icky it.
So that's, you know, used for dispatching the squid.
Yeah, correct.
And it's got a different, it's like a double prong.
Yep, that's just to sever the main kind of nerve inside the squid's head.
Right. So this whole Shimano Sephia range wouldn't be complete without a lure. We're very fortunate in the Shimano range to have the clinch lure. It's quite a unique squid lure. And Johnny, what are some of the features about, you know, these lures that we're using?
So these lures all have the flash boost system in them. And that's a foil that's suspended on springs on either end. So the whole time it's sort of shimmering and flashing so that it makes the lure really look like it's alive, even when you're not physically working it.
All right, and that flash boost system is unique to Shimano. It's a patented system, and it really brings that lure to life, like you were saying.
Yep. These lures are also available in three sizes. So we've got a 2.5, a 3, and a 3.5. And the 3.5s are actually what we call a super deep lure. So they're perfect for deeper water or high current areas because they get down faster.
Right, so that's something that you could possibly use if you're fishing off the boat or something?
Yep, or even just in the harbour where there's a bit more current, you know.
So today we're fishing in reasonably shallow water, not much current, so we're using number 2.5s and also a number 3.
Another cool feature we've introduced on the 3.5s is we now have Lumo models. So we have three, a pink one, a green one, an orange, all Lumo. And we have natural bait fish patterns with scale boost too, which really imitate the bait that the squid are feeding on.
Yeah, right. So that's going to be good in those deeper areas.
Yeah, sure.
Weed, big long weed edges.
And the Lumo, obviously, for your nighttime fishing.
Yeah.
Also in our Shimano flash boost lures, we also have a chimera coating on these lures. So that actually reflects UV light. So when you put them in the water, they actually light up. So that lure will actually pretty much look blue under the water. Squid can pick that up and it makes them far more attractive.
Today I'm really fortunate enough to be fishing with Dmitriy. Dmitriy's been squid fishing now in New Zealand for almost a decade. And we really want to get inside your head, mate, and learn some of these techniques. So Dmitriy, is there actually a correct name for this style of fishing?
Yes, there is, Tony. It's called egging. So the technique itself, or the method of fishing, was developed in Japan. It's believed to be over 200 years old now, so it was new technology. Anyone can start fishing now for squid. It's gained popularity over the years.
I mean, New Zealand's a perfect place for it. I mean, you've got rocky coastlines pretty much everywhere.
That's right, and places like here, standing on the rocks, amazing visibility, weed lines. Squid like to hang around these sort of edges with weeds, seek a bit of shelter and protection, and also use it to ambush the prey. But you don't have to be places like this. You can squid fish in the city after work, so it's accessible for everyone.
So Dmitriy, there's a really sort of like a dedicated, you know, gear and technique that we use for this style of fishing.
That's right. So we're in land-based fishing for squid. You want something around 8 to 9 foot. So advantage of having a longer rod is the castability, getting the jig to the right area.
And the technique that you're using is quite interesting. There's a lot of whipping involved in that.
Yeah, so whipping moves the jig through the water column, and then you let the jig sink for 5-6 seconds, depending on the sink rate and the area you're fishing, and then work it back to you. So squid will mainly attack the jig on the descent, so that's why you let it sink down and then work the jig back, which actually promotes them to bite.
Yeah. And you're talking about sink rate, that each lure's got a different sink rate?
That's right, yes. So 2.5 got a slightly lower sink rate than 3 or 3.5. So for areas like this, I prefer to use 2.5. Deeper water, I'll choose 3, 3.5.
Right, okay. So Dmitriy, with the setup, what is the different connections that you use?
So I basically run a series of 2 knots. So first knot being a FG knot, which connects your leader to your PE line. And that knot's really good for going through the guides. It's streamlined, it doesn't catch on the guides.
Yep.
So you get maximum distance with that knot. And the second knot is pretty basic uni knot. You can tie it to a clip, which makes it easy for changing jigs, or direct to the jig. And Rapala knot's also a pretty popular one.
And if you want to learn more about those knots, we have them in other videos within this series. Well, thanks Dmitriy for sharing all those
My pleasure.
Tips and tricks. I think it's time to get back to our squid fishing.
Let's do it, man.
Tell you what, you got the hooky here. So normally we just go right in there.
Oh, you can see it flash off when it dives.
One side, and then you kind of got to go like that. There he goes.
Well, the sun's gone down and I think this squid here is the perfect way to finish a great day squid fishing on the rocks. If you want to get into squid fishing or you're already into it, pop into your local Shimano retailer and check out the Sephia range. Adios.